going again. Today the aim for me here is to remove the back window, the panel, the two panels, and also the jrails. The whole idea is to basically have a look inside and make sure that everything is sealed properly as part of the window reseal process. But this one here, I'll take a little bit more out and clean it up. Now, if you've seen my introduction video, you would have noticed that there was a whole lot of white paint on here. There was paint splashed all over this back panel here, and there was also paint underneath this section here. And you can see that I've taken most of it off. There's still a little bit there that I need to remove, and also on the other side there's still a little bit more that I need to remove. But effectively I've taken 99% of it out, and it looks a hell of a lot cleaner now, as you can see here. So the other thing I've done too, and you can see here, it's a bit of a mess. I've still trying to work in here, but I've removed the back panel, the one that sits on the side, on either side of the window. You can see how nice that is there. Okay, I've also removed this edging strip here, and all that's got to be cleaned up before I put back the window. And here are the strips. These have been fairly damaged over the years, so I've tried to clean up as much as I can, but it's never going to be perfect, so I've just got to live with it. That's the way it is. Again, coming back to that mindset that this is a 50-year-old caravan, and therefore unless I'm going to start gutting it and replacing everything with new, that's not going to be the case. So I've just got to live with it. The other thing I'm going to do as well is, with these windows, they need to be, this is perspex, so obviously there's a little bit of an issue on the corner here. I need to buy the window stays, and I've already got these that I can replace, so needs a little bit of servicing on there as well. Right, so coming back to the exterior, the process is undo the screws for the window. Once I've undone that, undo the screws for the J-rails. It's only from here down to here, so it's not bad. And then once I've undone that, then pop rivet and unscrew. There's some screws here that have been used, so remove the two panels, and that will effectively expose the entire frame that you saw on the inside. So as before, just lever this out slowly. But the top here is a problem because I can't put this tool under there, so I just have to go slowly by hand. There we go. Same with under here, not much leverage. But it's just a matter of going slowly. Unfortunately, there's a few broken screws here, and it's causing it to lock. So I've got one broken screw there and one there, and that's causing this not to come out. It's almost out. You can see at the top here, it's all pretty loose now. Okay, so I've got the disc on. today. I'll have to dress that up as best as I can later on. But I suspect that it's still got thread that's going to be a problem. Anyway, let's give it a shot. Done the trick. All right, we'll clean those up later. So now what I'll need to do is see how I can remove that and that one and that one. So anyway, there's a bit to do there. And as I did with that window over there with the previous video, the window reseal video, I'm just going to clean all that up. I'm not going to repeat it here, so I'll just clean all this up. And the next step now is to undo these two, one on this side, one on the other side, these two jar rails. I forgot to mention too, I'll also need to remove this rail up here, because you can see the sheeting for the roof or the ceiling comes down to here and it overlaps that sheet here as well. So I need to remove these two strips, one on each side as well. Some of these flathead screws, see if I can get that in focus, can tend to be problematic. So what I suggest you do is do what I have here, have a range of flathead screwdrivers with kind of slightly different profiles, because I had to end up using this one here to remove a stubborn one. These two wouldn't work. So it goes to show you again, when you're dealing with old fasteners, that particularly if you can see that the heads are a little bit bunted, you may need to experiment with the tools. Now, I've just taken those off, and it's just a matter of dropping that there, and I'm just going to put it on the right side of the window so I know where it's come from. I've also taken off the screws of this J-rail, so I'm going to be using the same principle as before, using one of my favorite tools. Oh, they come out relatively easy, and again you can see that's all pretty dried up. Right, and now we've got all that. This top railing was held in by the screws and that profile bar, and now all I've got to do is just remove these, and theoretically I think that should be pretty much ready to slide out. Because it's tucked in under there, I suspect I'm going to have to pull the sheet out and then down, but we'll get to that in a sec. So I've got all those removed here, and we'll start to gently pry this out. Now there could be other fasteners that I haven't seen, like here's another broken screw. So I need to watch out for things like that. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 pop rivets to pop out, and all of this is super dry. This stuff hasn't been touched in many years. Okay. So there's those 4 gone. We should be able to now, hopefully. Oh, see, that's popped under there as well. There we go. Gently. Looks like there might be something just there that's holding it.
Yep,
check and it out. One last more pop of it. This one looks like it's a bit of a tricky one. Alright. So, once again, and there we have it. And there's the frame. So now, weather's been a bit unpredictable. I've shown you how to do this side. I'm not gonna show you how to do the other side because it's effectively the same. So I'm gonna do the other side and then I'll get cleaning. Okay, there we have it, the whole lot out. Next step is to clean it, make sure it's all perfectly cleaned. There is a little bit of, where is that over here, Sikaflex that I've got to remove. Also here. So it's quite a bit of work here to clean this entire section up. So all I'm doing at the moment is first trying to get rid of the bigger pieces. Okay, so it takes a bit of time, but at least if you get rid of the bigger pieces now, it's not going to interfere when you start using a rag and turps to clean the rest up. Okay, so this gives me an opportunity to remove any broken rivets, screws, etc, etc. And then the rest of it should come up nicely. So I've already started cleaning this area here. Okay, this is as close as I get to being clean. Bearing in mind there was paint, silicone, liquid nails, and everything else on there. So it's actually turned out a lot better than what it was. Down here, we've cleaned these up, and what I'm going to do too is we're going to put back the plates, position them first, and then where, so these are the screw holes, some of them aren't, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually put pop rivets where those other screws aren't. Obviously I won't be able to do them for all of them, but anyway, so that's this bit. And the side here, all nicely cleaned up as well. So it's looking a lot better now. Okay, so this frame is now clean. And we started to now put the first panel back in. be able to put a few of the pop rivets, and then we'll put the other side. So in order to determine which ones will be pop rivets and which ones are the screws for the jrail, we just positioned it in place like that, and I just did a very faint pin mark, and where the pin mark wasn't, that's where the staples are. And I also put the one up here, and now we need to do the same with this side here with the window when we get to it. But at this point in time, we can now position the jrail and the top strip. Okay, the other side, put some pop rivets, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and of course same deal up here. So this one is now in place, looking much better already. So now I'll be screwing the jrail and the top strip, and for the top strip I'll put a tiny bit of mastic on it, and for the jrail I'll be putting quite a bit, like I have with the windows. Okay, I'll clean this up anyway. It's done. Huge amounts. See happening up there is when I slide it across, I'm going to end up just put that up there for a minute. So there we have the excess, which we'll scrape off later, and similarly we'll have excess coming out here, and if we don't, I'll just add some more in there. Just to leave it a little bit loose for a bit. A So here's the window frame, obviously. That's there. We're giving that a bit of a clean. A bit of a dip going through with the Karcher. But what I've done here is I've actually pulled the window apart and I've drilled a couple of more drain holes there, giving it a nice bit of a clean inside. It was actually crap going in there. And doing the same for the top half. And so I've got new stainless steel screws and effectively just putting them back together again. Okay, we just screwed in the rear window frame. As you can see here, I bought all new screws for that. And just like before, plenty of excess that we can scrape off. And one of the things I've also done here is I bought some nice little rivet supports. I'm not sure what they're called, washers. I'm not sure, countersunk washers. But anyway, adds a little bit of a touch to that. Unfortunately, there's a whole lot of other holes that has been drilled in the past, I guess, for the air conditioning unit. But at the very least, these look good. So you saw when I was adding the mastic, how much I was adding to it. And again, just as the other window, you can see that it has definitely come through. Okay. And of course, I've got to clean that up. Now, the difference is I haven't added the flashing or the trimming or whatever you want to call it. And the reason why I haven't added that yet is because I need to actually put the cladding in first. Sorry, the ply in first. Once I got the ply in, then I can put that strip in. And because the fastening or the rivet holes are actually away from the window, I'm actually able to put those in fairly easily. And then of course I've got to clean up all the window and all that. It looks pretty terrible at the moment. So it's all complete now, with all the excess trimmed off. Put those back in. So next stage is to put that ply back on. And that was the template that I have here. And so I'm aiming to use exactly the same, except probably add a few more mil on the top and use the same drill holes, as I've already punched out the rivets. And from an outside perspective, you have it here. So I'm pretty happy with that. The only thing I can suggest is that when you're putting the butyl mastic in and you've got the excess coming out, actually clean that up as quick as you can within the first 10 minutes or so. Now, because this was quite hot, it actually became more difficult to clean up the excess. And it actually kind of leaves that stain there, which is removable by using, you know, mineral turps, but it just means that there's a lot more work. So this was a fairly mammoth effort. Probably took us 8 hours to do this today, from this morning till now. Especially the final touches. These things here, I'm glad I've put these extra bits on. Just makes it look a little bit more tidy. Now this top window frame here is actually not correct for this outer frame. We've had nothing but trouble with that, and I'm actually looking at replacing that in the future with one that's got the same profile here is that one. And of course, I need to really clean up this frame to make it look as best as you can. So there you have it. That's another task. I think one of the major tasks in terms of fiddly and having to, you know, do things, work around things and so on. But I'm quite happy with the result compared to what it was like originally. And now another window that won't leak. All right, as always, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just post on the comments. I always reply to my comments. So anyway, enjoy. Until next time.